Tenemos a Marty de Estados Unidos, fue el campeón mundial en los años 96, 97, corredor también de calle. Well, Marty, how you been in Puerto Rico? How has your time enjoying here in Puerto Rico?
So far, so good. You know, it's a beautiful island, and it's my first time here, and I'm extremely pleased with what the cycling community does, and the weather and the riders has just been fantastic.
Some rumors that you have been in a lot of cold here in Puerto Rico, right?
A lot of what?
Cold. It's very cold,
yeah.
The weather.
It was a little cold for me, you know, being from Pennsylvania, it was a little bit cold for me, but no, just, I don't think it ever gets cold in Puerto Rico.
And well, how are you enjoying this activity today?
Oh, this is fantastic, you know, to come and support an event, you know, to find a cure for diabetes and participate with over, you know, 300 riders for the Tour de Cure has just been a great experience for me.
You expect to come next year?
I would love to come next year, yes.
Yep. Well, you told me that you are working in the Pennsylvania at the Velodrome, right?
Yep, I run the Velodrome in Pennsylvania. It's a track I grew up racing on, so, you know, still very involved in cycling. My children race bicycles. I'm still involved with it every day, and, you know, to be able to come down here, enjoy cycling in Puerto Rico has just been a great experience for me.
Marty, a message to all the fans who look on the webpage and from word from a champion like you.
You know, cycling is a very special sport. We just have to continue pushing it hard and support the sport, support the young riders in the sport of cycling, and make room for the next generation.
So, Marty, thank you very much. Have a good day.
I'm here today here in Arteria in Puerto Rico on the Tour de Cure.
Love Puerto Rico, my fifth time here, having a wonderful experience. The weather's cooperating, 700 plus cyclists out here today at the Tour de Cure. Could not be happier. And these guys ride hard, man. It was a tough ride this morning.
Yeah, yesterday, Marty and you was in Cuomo with some activity there. How you explain the activity? How goes the activity there yesterday?
Ran a track cycling clinic for a variety of cyclists. Went off very, very well. Got in the car right away. Came out to Aguadilla to do a presentation at the Velodrome. Ran another clinic with some fixie riders. And overall, we've been having a great time. Got up early for the Tour de Cure this morning. And while it's a little bit of a whirlwind tour, you know, I always enjoy coming down. And yeah, it's great. We're loving it.
About your experience, you think that Puerto Rico have some talent to increase the talent and try to someday have an Olympics? What do you think?
I'll say this. I'm married to a Trinidadian woman. I was high performance director for Trinidad and Tobago. I've been traveling throughout the Caribbean since the 1990s. And what I find is that there is a wealth of talent in the Caribbean, especially in Puerto Rico. This is a large island, 3.4 million people. There's a wealth of talent here. And what we find is that sometimes there's just a basic lack of infrastructure and development, talent identification schemes, et cetera, that become impediments or infringements to cycling progressing or cyclists progressing through the ranks. So the talent's here. It's just a matter of FESIPER and other organizations doing their best to call that talent to bring it up to an Olympic standard.
A guy like you, you think that you can come here to Puerto Rico and try to increase talent here in Puerto Rico? What do you think?
It's one of the reasons I'm here. You know, it's my fifth time here. I've been working with a number of cyclists within the community to help develop programs, developmental programs, and to introduce that infrastructure, that world-class infrastructure, into the Puerto Rican environment.
So, well, words to all the fans who visit my webpage, what do you think?
I say ProCiclismo.com, numero uno, all right? Viva Puerto Rico, viva Ciclismo.